looks cool, right?
Hey guys, this is Richa from XPRO Elementor Addons.
And learn with me
how I create this cool visual transformation for free using the Before and After widget by XPRO.
So whether you are running fitness, skincare, dental, portfolio, any kind of website, this cool widget lets you create an interactive before and after slider, allowing the users to slide it back and forth to see the changes between the two images.
First, make sure to install and activate the free XPRO Elementor plugin. You can find the link in the description box below. And you can also find a video on how to install and activate it on a YouTube channel. So make sure to install and activate it to make amazing videos. Now, without any further ado, let's get started.
So here you can see this website with this cool before and after widget. Let's delete it and remake it from the scratch. In the search panel, let's search for the before and after widget by XPRO and then simply drag and drop it over here. Easy, right? Now let's add content. In the content tab, we have before, after in settings. Let's hit the before. Here you can see the label. You can type whatever you want to display. Like antique, it's just an example. I'm going to type before. Next we have the image option where you can either upload from your computer or select from the media library. You can also insert a URL of the image. If you want to select directly from the web, I'm selecting from the media library. Next, you can set the image resolution. Under the image resolution tab, we have multiple options like thumbnail, medium, large. I'm selecting full. Select the resolution that suits your needs. We're done with before, moving forward to after. In the label, I'm going to type after. Now selecting the after image that I want to compare with the before image. In the image resolution, selecting full. Then comes the setting. In the orientation, we have four unique orientations. Vertical. You want to have vertical direction. Then there's diagonal left. Next is diagonal right. I like the horizontal orientation. You can select whatever you like. Next is the display label, in which you can select if you want the label to display it always or to appear when hovering the mouse like this. I am selecting the hover option. Then we have the display handle option. Just like the label, you can select whether you want the handle to be displayed always or to appear when we hover the mouse. I'm selecting always. I don't like how the image appears without the handle. Next, we have the move on hover option. By selecting the show option, the slider moves and shows before and after with the hover. And if you want the users to click and drag, then select the hide option. I want the click and drag, so enabling the hide option. If you like the hover, then go for it. The next cool feature we've got is the wiggle. As you can see the slider wiggling, turn it on and the slider gets its groove on, wiggling around. Not a fan? No worries. Just hit hide and it will stay still. It's all up to you, wiggle or not. I'm selecting show option. You can make the animation wiggle slow or fast by adjusting this wiggle delay slider. Let's try one. No, it's a little fast. 2. Nope. 2.5. Yeah, 2.5 it is. Next is the visible ratio slider. This slider lets you control how much of each image you want to show. Slide it to the left and you'll see more of the after. Slide it to the right and the before image becomes more visible. Set it in the middle at 50 and both images will be displayed equally. I like 50. Okay, we're done with the content tab. And now let's move to the styling tab and do some styling. In the style, we have general, label, separator. Let's style the general first. Here we first have height. You can adjust the height of the image by adjusting the slider. You can also type it. Let's try 100. It's a bit big. 90. No. 80? 80 it is. Next is overlay colors. Adds a color layer to the image. They're like a spotlight highlighting a difference. You can select any color from this color option. I would suggest selecting transparent color for clarity. Users can swipe or click to reveal the transformations. It looks pretty cool, right? Then we have a label. Here we have typography. Let's check it. Oh, but let's first enable display label always so you can see the changes without the need to hover every time. In the typography, you can select any font like Arial, Verdana, Times New Roman. I'm selecting Poppins since it is eye-catching and easy to read. Next is the size for the title. Adjust the size of title by adjusting the sliders or simply typing the size. Let's try 15. It's big. 10? Yeah, 10 looks good. Then we have weight. Here we have 100, 300, 500. I want something light, so 200 looks good. Next is transform. Here we have uppercase, in which all letters are capitalized, lowercase, opposite of uppercase, capitalized, in which only the first letter is capital. I'm selecting default. Next we have style. Here we have normal, italic, oblique. Italic and oblique are similar, but oblique is smoother. Then there is decoration. Here we have underline, overline, line through. I'm selecting default. Then we have line height. Here we can adjust the height of line like this. Next is letter and word spacing, but it won't work since we only have one word. You can adjust the letter spacing from here. In the word spacing, we can adjust space between the words. But since we only have one word, it won't create any spacing. It requires more than one word. Next, you can see we have before and after options. So you could style them differently or you could go for the same style. It's totally up to you. Let's go for a before first. In the alignment, you can align the labels either top, middle, or bottom. I like the middle alignment. Next is the color for the label. Let's select something. I like the white color. If you like to have a color for the background, then play around with this background color option. This color looks cool. Now let's style the after label. In the alignment, you can align it differently, but I'm keeping the same alignment, that is center, that is middle. Next is the color for the label. You can have a different color. I'm selecting white, same as before. Now the background color, keeping it same. Okay, next we have the border type, where we have multiple options like solid. The border appears around both labels, double, dotted, dashed. I like the solid one. We can increase or decrease the border thickness from here, from this border width option. As we've selected the after label, the border color appears in the after label. Now let's go back to the before label and select a border color. Next is the color for the border. You might be confused that we just added colors, then what's this? Don't worry, I'm here for your rescue. Let's first select a color from this color option. The color isn't visible right now. It's okay. Don't worry. Let's go back to the border colors we have set. And now let's reset them. Now you can see the color that we have selected. If you want both labels to have the same color, then use this color option. If you want to style them differently, then you have to set the color. From the border color option present in the before and after, I'm selecting default in the border type. The next cool option is border radius. It adds a softer look. If we type 10, the sharp edges become a bit softer, and by typing 20, it becomes radial from all sides. I like the 20 pixels. Next is padding. Padding is the distance between the empty spaces. We can increase or decrease it like this. I'm keeping it to -1 from all sides. Next is the margins. You can increase or decrease the margins of the labels from here. Oh, one more thing, you can also unlink and set the value separately, just like I'm doing it for the border radius. Same goes for the padding and margins. We're done with the label section, moving forward to the separator. Here we have the line size. If you want to have a thick slider, then simply increase the size. And if you want to have a thin slider, then simply decrease the size. I like needed too thick, not thin. So I'm adjusting it to 3. Yeah, 3 looks nice. Next we have normal and hover options. Let's play with the normal option first. Here we have an icon color. Let's select a color from this color option. I like the black color. You can also add a colored background to the icon. I like it at white, so keeping it to white. Then there is color for the line. You can select the color from this color option. I'm keeping the same white color, just like the icon background. Okay, so let's move to the hover option. Let's select white for the icon color and black for the icon background. Let's keep the line color black as well and see the magic. But I don't need the hover, so I'm gonna just stick with the normal option. Now let's try the border option. Here you can add border around the icon, like solid. Oh, it's not visible. Let's first change the border color. Let's try black. Now let's try the border options. You can increase or decrease the border width from here. Next is border radius. If you like to have the slider with square edges, then just type 1, or if you like, and for radial, you know the trick, add 20 to all sides. And the border type, I'm selecting default. I don't need the border radius, so resetting it. Okay, we're done with the separator. Oh, here's one thing. If you don't want any labels, then just simply go to the labels in the content tab and clear the text. And this way you won't have any labels. I like the labels, so I'm keeping it. And in the settings, let's again select display label on hover. And that's it. Let's have a look at what we styled. Wow, it looks pretty cool, right?
So this is what you can do with this free amazing widget by XPRO. Don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to our YouTube channel for more amazing videos.